This is a follow-up to my previous camera tutorial video. My OV7670 project already has the capability to send image over the USB cable. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set it up. Download and open live OV7670 project. Link is in the description box. Now switch to setup.h and change example 1 to example 3. This activates example UART-CPP, which is required for this tutorial. Here I have made 4 pre-configured modes. By default, it is 320x240 resolution and baud rate at 1 megabit per second. Mode 1 is the same resolution, but baud rate at 2 megabits per second. But at least for me, this is unreliable and has glitches in the final image. The third mode is 160x120 resolution at 1 megabit per second. It is smaller resolution but faster. And the fourth mode is also 160x120, but it is much slower. It is for debugging if you have glitches at higher baud rates. Later I will demonstrate all the different modes, but now let's load the default 320x240 at 1 megabit per second to the Arduino. Next, download the Java-based Arduino ImageCapture project. Link to the GitHub page is in the description box below. You can also use Eclipse or compile it on the command line, but since I am used to using IntelliJ IDE in my everyday work, I am going to use that for demonstration. You can download IntelliJ Community Edition for free. Click Import Project, then select the project folder you downloaded from GitHub and press OK. Next, 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 next. I have JDK already installed, but if you don't have it, you have to go to Oracle's page and download it. Then you can click this plus sign and add your installed JDK version. And finally click Next and finish. Now click on this little arrow and edit configurations, plus and application. Name the configuration and select main class. Now it compiles, but when we try to run it, it will complain that it cannot find the libraries. So we need to add Djava.library.path to the VM options. I have 64-bit version of Java for Windows. If you have something else, then you can modify the path accordingly. After a successful build and run, you should see this window pop up. Select the same port that was used in the Arduino IDE for programming the microcontroller and select 1,000,000 since that is the mode we used for the live OV7670 project. If you see a red rectangle like this, then this means that the Java application and Arduino are both working properly. If it doesn't appear in a couple of seconds, then try pressing the reset button on Arduino board. While making this video, I discovered that for some reason the Genuine Arduino Uno cannot handle the 1 megabit per second baud rate. The red rectangle is always glitchy at the right edge. This problem does not exist with Chinese Arduino clones. For a Genuine Uno, you can switch the communication mode to 4 to use a lower baud rate. Another unfortunate thing is that either macOS or the rxtx library for Mac doesn't support 1 megabit baud rate. It fails to open the serial connection. So if you try to use it on Mac, you have to load UART mode 4 to Arduino and use a lower baud rate. In terms of wiring, it is easier than the screen version, since you only have to connect the camera. For this project, you need the non-FIFO version of OV7670, Arduino Uno, preferably a Chinese clone, since it works with 1 megabit baud rate. A bunch of wires. I didn't separate pixel wires, because then the wiring is a bit less messy. Two 10K resistors for the I2C connection. One set of 1K and 680 ohm resistors to create voltage divider for X-clock. And of course a breadboard. Let's start by creating two power rails for 3.3 volts and for ground. Then we can wire the constant power connections. Camera's 3.3 power input and reset pin to 3.3 volt power rail. Camera's ground input and power down input to ground rail. Next, we are going to create a voltage divider for the X-clock signal. 1 kilo ohm resistor to the ground and 680 ohm resistor to the pin 3 side of the voltage divider. And camera's X-clock pin between the two resistors. Two 10K resistors to pull I2C signals up to 3.3 volts. I2C clock pin A5 is connected to camera's data clock pin. I2C data pin A4 is connected to camera's data pin. Now we can do a midpoint test. Before we saw a red rectangle, but now if everything is connected correctly, we should see a green rectangle. If you don't see it in a couple of seconds, then press reset button on Arduino. If it still doesn't appear or you see a red rectangle, then check your wiring. There will be no picture yet, since pixel data wires are not connected. Now rest of the connections to read pixel data. Arduino pin 2 connects to camera's VSync pin. Arduino pin 12 connects to camera's pixel clock pin. For pixel data, Arduino pins A0 to A3 must be connected to camera's D0 to D3. Arduino pins D4 to D7 must be connected to camera's D4 to D7. And now you should start seeing images from the camera. It is pretty slow since serial connection is slow. It is only 1 megabit per second, while the SPI connection to the screen was 8 megabits per second. Let's switch it over to mode 1 with 2 megabits per second baud rate. As you can see, there are random glitched rows. It seems that sometimes a pixel byte gets lost and this messes up the line. Mode 3 with lowered resolution. This is much faster, but the image is very small. And mode 4 with significantly lower baud rate. Thank you for watching.